driving back from Charleston, and I told her, I said, I think I want to write a song about a church basement. Do you think that's dumb? She goes, no, I can smell it. And we spent 2 hours of the drive going like, and there's folding chairs and they're rusted, and we described everything. And then it became more, you know, when I brought it in, and I think I grabbed you, Brandon, and sent you a voice memo, Chris and Chandler and Dante. And I said, if you're up for it this morning, and I think this was the first time that we had...
So scared to write that song.
Why?
Because you just came in with that. You're like, let's write about an old church basement.
Old church basement.
What angle are we going to come at this?
Well, and then I just had some words, you know, right? That could go somewhere explicit. But I said, you know, just the idea of simplicity, you know, like, I think it could say, like, you know, we don't always need lights and stages, you know, and there's nothing wrong with that, but... you know, and but every now and then it could get a little complicated, you know, something like that. And just to watch everybody jump in, it was so much fun. And I think what it does is it takes you back to a place, and not a physical one either, because sometimes we can overrate the physical place, or we can say, well, this is where I learned to worship God. But if you can find that place in you, then you can be like Jacob that said, you know, God is in this place, and I was not aware. And so through this project, through these songs, I'm praying that you can find the place in yourself that isn't self-conscious, or that isn't burdened down or layered with limitations and traditions of how God can move in your heart and your life. And so that was what is exciting to me about Old Church Basement.